Let me discuss about the state of equilibrium. It is in page number 146. In a reversible reaction, both forward reaction and backward reaction takes place simultaneously. At a certain stage, the rate of forward reaction is equal to the rate of backward reaction. So this state is called the equilibrium state. So a chemical equilibrium is a state in which the rate of forward reaction is equal to the rate of backward reaction. Chemical equilibrium, it is a state in which the rate of forward reaction is equal to the rate of backward reaction. So this equilibrium is also called the dynamic equilibrium. So dynamic equilibrium means it occurs both in forward reaction as well as in backward reaction. Chemical equilibrium, mainly it helps us to understand the nature of the reaction. Let us consider the decomposition of calcium carbonate. Consider the decomposition of calcium carbonate. This calcium carbonate decomposed to give calcium oxide as well as carbon dioxide. Actually, it is a reversible reaction. This reaction is a reversible reaction. The speed of the reaction can be determined because the reaction, it disappears quickly. If the reaction is carried out in a closed vessel, then it reaches the chemical equilibrium. In this stage, calcium carbonate decomposed to give calcium oxide as well as carbon dioxide. Okay, so the rate of decomposition of this calcium carbonate is equal to the rate of combination of these two, calcium oxide as well as carbon dioxide. Okay. So, the rate of decomposition of this calcium carbonate, that is equal to the rate of combination of calcium oxide as well as carbon dioxide. Okay, here one thing you have to remember, not only chemical changes, even physical changes also, it attains the equilibrium. If in a system only physical state is changed, then equilibrium is established. Okay, that is, there is no chemical change. So this change is called the physical equilibrium. Example, we can say fusion of ice and then evaporation of water. Water kept in a closed vessel, it evaporates and forms water vapor. Water vapor will not escape out of the container because this reaction takes place in a closed container. So, the vapor pressure is inside the container only. After some time, the water vapor condenses back into liquid water. At this stage, the volume of the liquid and gaseous phases remains constant since it is a physical change. So, this equilibrium is called the physical equilibrium. So, liquid water turns into gaseous form. Again, gaseous state, it changes into liquid. So, since it is a physical change, hence it is called a physical equilibrium. We can discuss about, do you know? It is in page number 146. The food is kept in the refrigerator to keep them fresh for a longer period of time. This is because the temperature inside the refrigerator is low. That is, the reaction rate is very less. The microorganisms that are found on the food spoils the food and stay alive at room temperature, and it cannot survive at the low temperature. That is why the food which is kept at the room temperature spoils more faster than the food kept in the refrigerator. Okay. Now we will discuss about the characteristics of equilibrium. First one, dynamic in nature. Actually, chemical equilibrium is dynamic in nature. It means that the reaction takes place in both the direction with the same speed. That is, in the forward direction as well as in the backward direction. That is why chemical equilibrium is dynamic in nature. Okay. In gaseous state, the reaction in closed vessel. To obtain equilibrium, the reactant or product, if it is in the gaseous state, the reaction should always be carried out in closed vessel. Otherwise, what happens? The reactant or product easily escapes out. Okay, so the reaction should be carried out in closed vessel. And third one, properties remains constant. At a given temperature and pressure of equilibrium, the properties like concentration, density, color, viscosity remains constant. That is, it is unchanged. Okay. Now the fourth point, in reversible reactions, equilibrium in closed vessels. Okay. So, in order to prevent escape of products, equilibrium is reached only in closed vessels in reversible reaction. Otherwise, product easily gets, it will escape out. Okay. So, it should be carried out in a closed vessel in reversible reaction. Next one, homogeneous equilibrium, same phase. In a homogeneous equilibrium is an equilibrium in which the reactants as well as the products, both it should be in the same phase, okay, or same physical state. For example, so look at the example, CH3CO2H5 is nothing but ethyl acetate, okay. So ethyl acetate, when it reacts with the water, it forms acetic acid as well as ethyl alcohol, okay. Here, ethyl acetate is nothing but liquid. It is in the liquid state. Okay. And water is also liquid. Acetic acid is a liquid. And ethyl alcohol is also the liquid. So, in a homogeneous equilibrium, it is an equilibrium in which both the reactants as well as products, it should be in the same phase. If you look at this equation, here the reactant as well as products, everything it is in the same physical state, that is in the liquid state. Okay, hence we say it is a homogeneous equilibrium. Next point is heterogeneous equilibrium, different phase. Here in heterogeneous equilibrium, it is an equilibrium in which here the reactants as well as products, it should be in different phase, that is two or more phases. Okay, let me see an example now. So look at the example, zinc, when it reacts with carbon dioxide, it forms zinc oxide as well as carbon monoxide. Here zinc is nothing but a solid. Carbon dioxide is a gas. Zinc oxide is a solid and carbon monoxide is a gas. If you look at this equation, the reactant part as well as in the product part, you will find two phases, two physical states are there. One is the solid phase and another one is the gaseous phase. Here also solid as well as gaseous phase. So, heterogeneous equilibrium is the equilibrium in which the reactants or products, it should be in different phases, that is two or more phases. That is called the heterogeneous equilibrium. Okay, so you can find two phases here. No, so this is one of the example for heterogeneous equilibrium. Okay, so these are some of the characteristics of equilibrium, right?